Good morning. Myself Jayachandran from CSA department, Sri Sainam Institute of Technology. Today we are going to discuss the fundamentals of programming, programming paradigm, and object-oriented programming basic concept. Shall we proceed? Right. First of all, I would like to explain what is the purpose behind making use of programming language, which are all the programming paradigm, the evolution about the programming language from the very beginning, which is the current programming language, the industry, the society we have been using. So this is what the concept today we are going to discuss. Right. Now, the basic idea I would like to tell you, I have a task of keying 100 page text information. After keying my job, I just wanted to store into my system. So this is what the task. Now, my choice is if I am going to perform this task, completing this task by using any of the available computer package, or if my choice is if I am going to make use of any of the programming language. So what are all the benefit about it? So what is called package? What are all the benefit? What is the purpose behind programming language? That is what first of all I would like to tell you. Right. Now, the chosen task here, I just wanted to type 100 page information into my system. So obviously my choice is MS Word. So what is the purpose? Why do I select this MS Word? Means that the general purpose behind the package. Package is a ready-made software. Whichever the requirement, the basic environment need by the user or the end user, which is already created by the developer. Simply, we are going to make use of the available environment. So that is the purpose of making use of package. So that is why the conclusion package is the ready-made software. So if I am going to start doing my keying job, easily I can type it. So after completing my keying job, I can store into my suitable file name. Then within an hour or within a couple of hours, the job can be completed, which depends on the typing speed about the user. But now the same job, my choice, if I am going to make use of any of the programming language, as a programmer, the basic environment I only going to design and develop. That is what the basic difference between making use of the computer package as well as the programming language. So if my choice making use of any of the programming language, the first window and each and every bar, the menu bar, status bar, scroll bar, so every bar I have to create. So for this creation of the package alone, it takes huge amount of time. That is the basic difference between the package and language. Right. Now the programming paradigm. Paradigm means that which are all the software evaluation about the programming language. Very beginning, the programming language is classified into low-level language and high-level language. Low-level language means that it is machine-level and assembly-level language. The machine-level language cannot be understood by the regular programmer or the regular persons. The machine only can be able to understand this is what the instruction, this is what the statement. Later we have got assembly language. So by applying some of the mnemonic codes, we can complete our programming. But later, both the assembly language as well as the machine level language is not easy to do for the programming world. That is why we have got the high level programming language. So the high level programming language, in which the programming paradigm, which starts from the basic C, C++, Fortran, COBOL, so many languages are there. So all those languages coming under high level programming language. But we can classify those languages into the many programming paradigms. I can say object-oriented programming, structural programming, procedural programming. So whichever the task can be split up into many procedure. By executing the individual procedure, we are able to complete our task. This is what the idea behind the procedural oriented. Then object-oriented means that the entire programming concept is divided up into many partitions. The partitioned portions are maintained by developed by individual class constructor. So that is what the main idea about the today's class. We are going to discuss the basic concepts of OOPs, object-oriented programming concept. Now we are going to discuss about the basic concepts of OOPs. The basic concept means that in structured oriented programming C, we have got the so many built-in data types and user-defined data type. Built-in data types already developed by the developers. So each and every built-in data type has some limitation. We can use that limitation, we can apply it. But the purpose behind user-defined data type is that depends on the situation, depends on the requirement. As a programmer, I able to construct my own data type. That is what user-defined data type. In C, we have array, structure, union. What is the structure and array concept in C? That has been developed, enhanced. Later we have got the entire full-fledged form of the specialized user-defined data type in the name of class. So class is the very first user-defined data type. This is the very, very essential concept in object-oriented programming. Right. Here, a class which is the combination of the data and associated functions. So the data and associated function means that, so which is the problem statement given scenario, based upon the scenario as a user I able to identify how many number of variables are there, what are all the data type about those respective variables, so I can declare those data within the class. And by applying those data, which is the actual manipulation I am going to perform, that is defined by using the member function about a class. So the conclusion, class is the combination of data and associated function, right? So a single class I able to construct many more objects. So object is the basic runtime entity, right? So making use of the class construct and the utilization of the classes can be done by using the object, right? Now the other basic concepts we are going to see here. The first one, data abstraction, data encapsulation, modularity, inheritance and polymorphism. The first one, data abstraction, right? What is the very essential information about your program or about your problem scenario that can be given in the term of data abstraction? So always the data abstraction gives you the very, very essential information. Say for example, in my program, how many number of classes are there, how many number of objects we are going to create for all those classes. So that is what the idea behind the data abstraction, data encapsulation. Here the actual rights about a class is called data and its associated function. What is the meaning about data encapsulation here? The set of data and associated functions are wrapping up into a single unit. So that is called data encapsulation, which is in other words called as data hiding. So data hiding is the very, very useful concept in C++, because the data security can be ensured through this concept. So whichever the data, I mean the members we have declared in the class, that can be reused, initialized. So anything can be done about the class members only can be done by the public member function. So member function about a class only can going to handle whichever the data declared in that particular class. So this is what the strength about a data encapsulation, which ensure the concept of data hiding and data security can be ensured. So the next, the modularity. The modularity is the base idea about object-oriented programming, which means that which is the source problem scenario or which is the taken program. So that single program is classified into many components. All those components are maintained by using the user-defined data type, whereas in name of the class. So we able to create n number of classes in the single program. All the classes can be maintained individually. In future, for any future enhancement, if I wanted to do any changes, updation about any particular class, so that class updation never affect rest of all other classes. That is what the benefit, why we have to do the partitioning the source project. That is what modularity. But what is very important here, when we are going to modularizing all those components, like in terms of class, the single mindedness, which means the high amount of cohesiveness supposed to be maintained. That is help us to make the program with a high amount of quality. So then it help us to meet the requirement which is given by the user. So which is the primary objective about the program? The objective can be fulfilled when we are going to modularize with the essential amount of modularity. So that is what The third concept, modularity. Next, inheritance. Inheritance is the mechanism of deriving new classes from the existing one. So, which is the very, very useful concept in all the basic concepts. So, we have created four number of classes. All the classes are independent classes. In future, I wanted to inherit new class. So, that can be done from the existing class. So, by deriving a new class from the existing class, that is the concept of mechanism. We call it as inheritance. So, inheritance can be done by the various method. The base class, I mean the source class is only one. From the source class, I am going to derive one derived class. So, that is called single inheritance. Then, the next type of inheritance, if I wanted to inherit many amounts of members, those members are available in more than one base class. So, if I am going to derive a new class, the new class derivation requires the some amount of members and member function plus from various classes, that is called multiple inheritance. And then the third type of inheritance, if I have derived one base class, from the base class I wanted to inherit one subclass, so derived one. From the derived, in future I want to derive another one. So base, derived one, derived two, three, n. So for all the derived cases, which is the base class, na, the first source class only. So this type of inheritance we call it as multi-level inheritance. And then the hierarchical inheritance. Hierarchical inheritance means that from the only the single class, I mean the source class, I can derive three number of classes or n number of classes. So from the derived one, I can go for further derivation. So this is the looks like a tree structure. This is what hierarchical inheritance. The last one, hybrid inheritance. Hybrid inheritance is the combination of any other two inheritance. Say for example, I just wanted to derive two derived classes from only one base. So this is called hierarchical inheritance. Then from the two derived classes, I just wanted to construct one new derived class, new child class. So this structure, base class, from the base I have derived two derived classes. Now even though the derived classes are child classes, for my future derivation I am going to construct the fresh class from the derived one. So that is what hybrid inheritance. Thank you.